legends, today I'm unboxing the Sneak Legacy box. I get that I'm a little bit late to the party with this. I did buy it on launch day. It was a pretty mad launch. Sneak have said that it was double the traffic at any one point they'd ever had on the website or something. So it was crazy. I tried to get a hoodie as well, but I got to the checkout and it's still 1 minute past. And I was trying to get the 4XL hoodie because I wanted it baggy. It was sold out. So I lost out on the hoodie. Then I ordered my Sneak. I wonder if I hadn't tried to get the hoodie, if I would have got my Sneak quicker, because this didn't actually get posted until yesterday, which would be Saturday, instead of it getting posted out on Friday. I wonder if it would have been posted out Friday if I hadn't tried to get a hoodie. Something I'm curious about. But let's unbox it, and we're going to try both flavours. You've got the unreleased and the blackout, and also the glow shaker, which I don't have. So it's three things that I've never had before, never tried in this video, which is quite exciting. Let's get it open. As always, I love the Sneak boxes. Sneak's packaging is always incredible. As sad as I was about this coming, I say late, it's not late because, you know, at the moment it says it can take an extra 2 days for delivery because of COVID anyway. Plus, you've obviously got the bank holiday weekend. It's not late really, but getting it a day after everyone else made me quite sad yesterday. I was kind of a bit salty about it. Right now, I'm just full on excited. Oh, my box is open. So as you can see, I haven't taken it out, it's open. What? It's come open. Also come with a little bit of a, kind of like a rip on that corner. That's a bit disappointing. Especially when it's an £80 like limited edition box. You want it all to be nice and the lid's bent. You can see it better from the back, but it's bent and it's open. Like, a bit disappointed with that, to be honest with you, because the other Sneak ones I've had, the Generations boxes, they were both minty fresh. And part of buying the box bundle is you want the box, you want the collector's box. It's actually more expensive than buying the starter stacks. You can buy the starter stacks and get a bit of money off. This is 80 quid. You can get like a shaker and a tub in like a cheaper deal. So you can actually get it cheaper if you don't get the box. So I've paid more money to get the box and the box is just crushed anyway. It's got another bend there. I'm really sad about that. I was so hyped for this. So anyway, I love the legacy design. I wish Sneak would do a legacy type like merchandise line. I would love to see like a Sneak Legacy hat with that logo on. I'd be all over that, especially if it's a red one. Let's see what we get inside anyway. Let's try and get back to being hype. So this is the glow in the dark shaker. I don't know what it's actually called. It's a glow in the dark shaker. One subtle difference with this compared to when they originally did it is it has got a red mixer inside. That's just so people can tell if you've got like the V1 or the V2. So they've done that just to make it obvious whether you've got the new one or the old one. They have apparently also done that with the color of the drink once it's mixed. So you can tell if it's the new one or the old one. Apparently the blackout one doesn't have like black coloring in. It's just the color the flavor would be. Not sure what blackout looked like because I've never tried blackout or unreleased before, so I'm super hyped to try them in a minute. But yeah, the shaker is well nice. It's one of the nicest shakers I've probably seen from Sneak. I love it. I love the dripping bunny. Don't know how much it glows in the dark. If I can get a picture of it glowing that looks good, I will chuck that in the video right here. But yeah, it's cool. I like it. Even without it glowing, it's cool. Hopefully when it glows, it's even cooler. Next in the box, we have Sneak Unreleased. Now, I believe this was supposed to be Sneak's like original flavor. I like how it's got that little tab to seal it. Other Sneaks don't have that. That's a pretty nice little touch. I love the branding on this one. It's kind of almost, it reminds me a little bit of, you know, Off-White, the brand Off-White. It reminds me a little bit of that kind of vibe. I like it. I'm excited to try this one. Next up is the Blackout, which has even got a blacked out lid. I'm excited to try this one as well because I didn't get it. It came out on like a Black Friday many years ago, or 2 or 3 years ago. And I did actually try and get it, but I just missed it because my payday was slightly after when it came out. So I was like, no, I'll just wait till payday. I'll be sensible. I wish I'd just pulled the trigger, but I get to try it now. So I'm super hyped. And last but not least, you have a little cardboard box which stood the shaker up. I thought it was going to be solid, but it's actually not. I thought these were going to be kind of like joined together. If these were joined together, you could have kind of kept that on your desk as a little plinth. But it's just junk and it's a bit disappointing. Just want to mention as well, if you've watched my Generations video, there's no stickers in this box. They didn't say there was going to be stickers, but there was a little part of me that just hoped for it. I haven't watched anyone else unbox it because I wanted this whole thing to be like a surprise. And no stickers. I would have loved some sneaky, if you pardon the pun, some sneaky little stickers in there would have been awesome. But let's get on to the sneak. That's the main event. We're going to do Blackout first because it's the one that I picked up. Nice tub though, really like that. Before we try it, just for those that have never tried any sneak, sneak is basically a vegan, sugar-free, low-calorie alternative to a Monster or something like that. It's a similar product to gfuel, if you've heard of those. But it's from the UK. They do sell it in the US as well, but it's UK-based, and I really like it. Just quickly, on the note for people that have not ever tried sneak before, if you go into the description or the pinned comments, there is my referral link, which basically gets you a good deal on a little starter bundle where you get some sachets and a shaker so you can try it out and see what you think. And your boy Link gets some elite points, which is a Sneak's reward scheme. So please click that link if you've never tried Sneak before and give it a go because I think you'll probably like it. Even got a little blacked out lid. I'm here for that. Oh, we're looking like a purpley kind of color. Don't know if I can show that without tipping it out. Smells like some sort of berry things going on. Almost like a black cherry. As it's purple, I will mix that in the Purple Storm shaker. Does anyone else feel like a chemist or something when you're doing that? Do you feel like some sort of mad scientist? So just to mention, a lot of people argue about how much water and stuff to have. What I go for now is 400ml of water, 100ml of ice, which makes 500ml plus your powder. I nearly got too excited and started shaking it up before we cued the old steel pans. Cue the music. Shake montage time. So here we have it. I don't know what color that is. It's kind of red. Smells like black cherry. I have a glass so we can investigate its color through a transparent receptacle. Good old fashioned JD glass. Oh, it is red. Look at that. Color of that, it's almost glittery, a bit like Blizzard. I don't know if that's just because it's not mixed that good or if it is glittery like Blizzard was, which had like the little glitter in, which I love. Blizzard probably my favourite sneak. I've still got a soft spot for Blizzard. Let's try it. It doesn't smell it too much, but hopefully it tastes good. Yeah. More of like a black cherry. It's quite similar to Cherry Bomb, but it's more like a black cherry. I like it though. It's a little bit like Monster Ultra Black, which I reviewed recently on the channel. It's that kind of black cherry. Obviously liked it, I wouldn't have drunk it all. As always, everything on the channel gets scored out of 10. I am gonna give that a solid 9 out of 10. Really nice, great flavour, it's punchy, it's powerful. But there isn't an X factor. For anything to get a 10 out of 10, it's gotta have like something special. It's gotta be like pow for me to give it a 10. Unfortunately, it was really, really good, but it just didn't have something that blew my mind. Now, this is the one I'm really excited about. I'm gonna try and rip that like that with my fingernail so I can open that. That one's got the more sort of traditional sneak lid on. Tough to get this one open. Oh. That does not look or smell like I expected it to. It's kind of like a peachy colour. Almost like a fruity scent, but not, I wouldn't say it's peach. Maybe apricot or something. Let's find out. It's really, really hard avoiding like spoilers for this because everyone is talking about it and I've got mine a day later than everyone else, but I'm excited. But I have sort of ignored everything everyone else has said. I've not looked at it so I can make my own mind up. Okay, the peach powder's in. It's already going a bit yellow. The V1 Blizzard Shaker, the OG shaker. Well, it's not the OG shaker, there was a shaker that sneak called the OG, but the OG Blizzard Shaker. Cue the montage. The veil of the Blizzard Shaker looks like a pinky colour. But as always, let's chuck it in the glass, see what it really looks like, because sneak don't make many transparent shakers. That would be a big, big request for me, like a crystal shaker. Call it the crystal or something where it's just all clear. Give me a transparent lid, give me a transparent at the bottom. Get on it. To be fair, this is probably the most transparent sneak shaker I have. My new one, but it's not washed up, so we can't use that. Right, is it going to be pink? No, it's orange. I poured way more than I meant to. It's all going wrong. Right. There you go. Very orange. Makes me nervous because orange fruits are not really my thing. It smells like sherbet. It smells like a dip dab. They should have put this in the old Generations line. Sneak Dip Dab edition. Okay. I feel you, Sneak. It was kind of glittery again. It's special. It's like sherbet, but it's orange. It's like orange sherbet is what it reminds me of. I feel like I'm eating a dip dab right now. I'm in a happy place. They're both very good. I think Unreleased has the edge over Blackout though. This thing here, right? It's special. The sherbet, orange flavour, the dip dab vibe. That's probably my favourite sneak yet. And I'm surprised I'm saying that. If you'd have told me it was orange flavour, I wouldn't have said that's going to be my favourite. If you'd have told me even it was orange sherbet, I would not have been in, but I'm all in on that. It's so sweet, so refreshing. That is the best thing sneak I've ever made. And now I'm kind of sad that it's like a limited edition thing. Because I've got 40 servings. And 40 servings is all I've got. And that makes me quite sad. But it feels really special to be drinking it when it was kind of like a limited edition thing. The fact Sneak brought it back, I absolutely love that. If they could just bring back Blankberry now, because that's the only flavour of Sneak I have not tried. Or if you got a spare one in the office, just send it to me to review, because it's the only one I haven't had. We've reviewed every flavour of Sneak on this channel now. I feel like we should start a campaign to get me some Blankberry, guys. I got carried away and forgot to score this out of 10. Obviously, being the best Sneak ever, it's a 10. But I got too excited and I forgot to say that. So yeah, just to be clear, 10 out of 10, Sneak Unreleased. The best there is, the best there was. I don't know if it's the best it ever will be, but it might be. Now the shaker, I didn't review the shaker, didn't give it a score out of 10. Basically, I want to see if it glows in the dark or not, so I'm going to go do that. and then I'm going to score it out of 10. This thin glow is really good. It's fairly transparent. It's definitely my favourite Snake Shaker I have. So I'm going to let Snake have another 10 out of 10 because I'm quite happy with it. Now, the Legacy box as a whole, I loved it in lots of ways, but I'm really, really sad about the little rip, especially with it being a black box. It's very obvious. I'm sad about this. I know this was just to hold the shaker in the box so it matched up with the tubs, but I'm sad that wasn't more substantial. That could have just one little bit of cardboard. Just give it corners and glue it together like that. Just glue it together like that and it would have been awesome. But it's not. It's a waste of my time. My box has got rips, so I'm pretty sad about that. I'm pretty gutted, to be honest, because my other ones, I kind of kept them for display, but this one's all ripped. And this one's my favorite box they've done in terms of the box design. In terms of the value, I don't like the fact that the box is more expensive than buying the stuff individually, especially when they're already limited edition items. The limited edition items as it is, so I get the collector's box, but if you're gonna make the collector's box more expensive, put something in it you can't get anywhere else, especially if the box is gonna be ripped anyway. If the box is gonna be ripped anyway, put some stickers in it. Just give me one sticker with that logo on justifies the higher price for me. Just one sticker, because you can use the stack 10 code and get the other thing cheaper. If that was a sticker, just that thing there, one sticker, I don't care about the price anymore. So for me, the box as a whole is just an 8. The reason it's still an 8 is because the products inside it were incredible, as they always are with Sneak. But I feel like in terms of a package, it's a bit weak. And part of me wants to knock the Legacy box down for the fact I couldn't get the hoodie. But I like stuff being exclusive. I like stuff being hard to get. I'm a collector, you know, I collect Funko Pops, I collect things. Part of the thrill was in the chase and I didn't get the hoodie. No big deal. It was a game and I lost. So I don't want to knock it down for that. But yeah, I love how exclusive it was. I love that people didn't get it. I'm gutted you guys didn't get it. If anyone's watching this and you didn't get it, I am gutted you don't get to try it. But I like that it's exclusive and that it didn't just re-release it in loads of stock, because it makes it special still. But hopefully they do little releases every now and then. Maybe they could do like a Legacy box with just sachets. Why don't you do like a Legacy shaker bundle, Sneak? You should bring back the Clutch It shaker, because I regret not buying that thing so much. Bring back the Clutch It shaker in a new Legacy bundle with just sachets of the other limited edition ones. You know, just do a Blizzard, an Unreleased, a Blackout, a Blankberry. I'll be a very happy man. But this was ripped, so like I say, it's still getting an 8 because it was quality and I loved it and I love everything inside it, but I'm just disappointed with the box, disappointed with the lack of stickers. Even though I knew when I bought it there wasn't going to be stickers, I had a bit of hope that Snake was going to sneak something in that box. And if I'd watched other people's unboxings, I probably wouldn't have had that disappointment at the start. But I didn't watch other people's unboxings because I wanted it to be a surprise. I wanted it to be organic and real. And I don't regret that, but I kind of do. If you enjoyed this, make sure you check out my Sneak playlist and my energy drink playlist over on my channel, where you can watch all my other energy drink videos. I've reviewed a bunch of different stuff, so go check it out. If you want to see more Sneak videos in the future, make sure you are subscribed to my channel, because I review every flavor of Sneak that comes out that I managed to get hold of. Some of the limited drops are a little bit tricky, like the Blankberry, that's the one I missed. So make sure you hit the notification bell as well, because when I put the next Sneak video up, the next energy drink video, you want to be the first one of my legends to get on that. Comment down below with what you guys think of Sneak Legacy. Did you cop? Did you not? Did you like it? Are you annoyed about how Sneak released it? Lots of controversy about Sneak not limiting how many one person could buy. Some people have bought 10 and some people are upset about that. Some people have put the box on eBay for £400. It's interesting, but for me personally, I'm not one of these people that really buys to sell. I get why people do it though, because there's money to be made. But a way to stop that is to stop buying from them resellers. Like, I want Blankberry, but all these people that are reselling Blankberry for like £120. Don't give in. As much as you want it, don't give in. If you don't give in to the resale prices, nothing will ever be sold over retail. It's like the PS5. Don't give in. It will never be sold for above retail. If everyone says, no, I'm not paying more than retail, the price doesn't go up. little rant, but I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like this video, obviously. Thank you for watching. I'm rambling here. I've been Link. Thank you for being one of my legends today. I will hopefully see you real soon.
Thanks so much for watching today, guys. If you've enjoyed that, you can click up here and you can watch another video of mine. Or if you really love it, if you really, really love it, or even if you just like it a little bit, go down here and subscribe to the channel. It means you'll never, ever miss what is coming up real soon.